everybody. So we made our practice balloons, which you guys got to take home. And we worked really hard at creating a good, even, smooth paper mache technique. Now for the group project. So the group project is where you guys are going to be in groups of four or five students together, paper mashing over a Chinese rice paper lantern. Now you'll notice that there's going to be wire on the inside that holds the shape, and this is paper. So what happens when paper gets wet, Mr. Robbie, do you know?
Oh, well, it can do two things. It can soak up the wet, but sometimes it gets fragile and can break.
Yeah. So when you're doing this, do you want to pour glue all over your lantern? No, because it will tear through the paper. So you want to wipe, like Mr. Robbie's doing, you're wiping really carefully, wiping that paper down, and then evenly, no air bubbles, carefully laying down your strips of newspaper all the way around, all the way to the bottom, carefully. Okay? So do it slowly, do it together. Some people can do this side, some people can do the other side. Have fun, carefully, making your paper mache.
Heading for the station with a pack on my back. I'm tired of transportation in the back of a hack. I love to hear the rhythm of the clickety-clack and hear the lonesome whistle, see the smoke from the stack, and pal around with Democratic fellas named Mac. So take me right back to the track, Jack. Choo-choo, choo-choo, jiboogie, woo-woo.
Okay, so what Mr. Robbie and I had to do was we needed to get to the other side. The balloon started falling, the lantern started falling and squashing. So we have turned it carefully over. One of us is holding it as we're sticking, so you need to work as a team. So if I'm over here gluing, this, dipping, wiping, Mr. Robbie's holding the balloon for me.
You need some compensation to get back in the black. You
take well, see, now I can hold it for Mr. Robbie as he goes around and gets these pieces. So if there's lots of you in this group, you need to work together, otherwise your lantern's going to look like the messy broken one. Do you want to be that group? No. You want the best lantern. Yours is going to be the best. No, yours. Yours over there. Yes. Yours is going to be the best. That person. Yeah.
Well, the one next to that person.
Yeah, theirs could be the best.
Yeah, yeah. No, I think you
Yeah, I think you all do really well if you work together. Okay, be careful. Keep going.
Settle down by the railroad track, live the life of Riley in the beaten down shack. So when I hear a whistle, I can peep through the crack and watch the train a rolling when it's falling a jack. For I just love the rhythm of the clickety clack. So take me right back to the track, Jack. Choo choo, choo choo.
How's it looking, Mr. Robbie?
Wow, that's
is it all great. So we can hang these up to dry overnight. You need to check that there's none of the rice paper of the lantern showing, and that it's nice and smooth, okay? If it starts to bend and lose its shape, maybe there's too much newspaper in that area. You want just one even coat of newspaper around the whole thing.
Like, I've got to say as well, Miss Mika, that was much easier to use on the balloon.
Yeah.
So you guys, with your experience already, we'll find this a breeze.
And we'll have nice hard shells to start painting around our lanterns. Okay? And then, what are we going to do? All the evidence you're gathering for historical aspects, you're going to start to collage and build your drawings and your paintings and maybe some information that you find or a historical quote, and you'll be building all around these. These are your group's historical bubbles. Good luck.
Excellent. Right. I'll go wash my hands though, Miss Mika. Stop eating it! Oh! Don't eat it! I'll just come in.
Head for the station with the pack on my back.
You're my world.
I love to hear the rhythm of the big
fluffy.